Most of today's astronomy is based on the detection of electromagnetic radiation in various frequencies, like radio waves, visible light, and X-rays, and on the detection of cosmic neutrinos. But there is another way to perceive the universe. As we know from Einstein's general theory of relativity, massive objects can also emit gravitational waves. Measuring these tiny ripples in space-time opens up a whole new field, gravitational wave astronomy. But we have the problem that the fabric of space-time is very stiff, and even very large objects are far away and cause only small ripples. This means that the measurable effect, that is the change in the distance between two objects, is also tiny. We already have several ground-based gravitational wave detectors all over the world. These detectors are L-shaped, and we call each line of the L one arm. There is a mirror at the end of each of these arms, with several kilometers of vacuum tubes in between. Using lasers, we can measure the relative length change between the two arms by reflecting light off the mirrors. This technique is called laser interferometry. Already, our detectors can measure arm length changes as small as a thousandth of a diameter of an atomic nucleus, that is a billionth of a meter. In order to make this work, the mirrors have to be really well isolated from the ground, so the only thing they detect is a passing gravitational wave. But, of course, there will always be some limits, because on Earth there are lots of disturbances. Cars, people, earthquakes, clouds, and many more. There is no way to completely get rid of this low-frequency noise. But we can detect gravitational waves at higher frequencies, produced by supernovae, rapidly spinning neutron stars, or two merging neutron stars. However, there is a solution that allows us to detect low-frequency gravitational waves. We can leave the Earth behind and launch our detector into space. This is the idea behind the planned laser interferometer space antenna. Instead of mirrors, the detector has some highly reflective cubic test masses, which are free-floating inside a satellite. This protects them from other forces, like the solar wind. When the solar wind pushes on the satellite, the so-called drag-free control system will steer the satellite to make sure it never hits the test mass. This means that the test masses only follow the deformation of space-time, and are isolated from all other disturbances. If we now take three satellites and form an L-shape again, we have a space-based detector, and we can measure gravitational waves from sources at much lower frequencies. Another advantage of putting our detector in space is that we are not limited in how big we can make the arms. We can put our test mass mirrors millions of kilometers apart. This makes us much more sensitive, so we can detect huge numbers of sources from the entire universe. So what can we learn about the universe with such a detector? Well, we will be able to observe some of the earliest black holes in the universe, discover thousands of ultra-compact binary star systems in our galaxy, and we can find out if Einstein's theory of relativity really is correct by looking at stars falling into black holes. We will observe the structure and expansion of the universe with a higher precision than ever before, and we might also be able to look as far back as the Big Bang, much further than we are able to see using the electromagnetic spectrum, and this will allow us to better understand the origin of our universe. Together, space and ground-based gravitational wave detectors will open a new field in astronomy and unlock the gravitational universe. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see new videos as they are released. And if you want to find out even more, visit our website or find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+.